There's a real nature in the industry of women being expected to just shut up and listen.
Don't let the fact that you're a girl deter you.
Not just thinking, oh, just, you know, throw a handful of women in there, being like, you know, it's 50-50.
The reaction I got in the end was a bit like, you could have tried a little bit better.
My name's Joelle David and I used to be a freelance assistant director, but I now run my own production company called Bluebird Pictures.
My name's Sophie Franklin and I'm an editor. I kind of try and specialise in documentaries as well, and at the moment I'm just a student studying editing and post-production at Ravensbourne.
So my
name's
Deepa Laxman. I'm a student at Ravensbourne, doing editing and post-production. But my background, I've come from a sort of social media marketing industry. I've been doing that for about 2 years, and prior to that I was working at Google for a year.
I'm Scarlett, I'm 19. I currently am in my first year of digital film production at Ravensbourne.
When I used to work at the Premier League, that was very male dominated, and I felt very put upon as a woman in terms of I was expected to do quite a lot of work and just grin and bear it. And when I complained about the amount of work that I was given, it was other people's work, it was other colleagues' work that I shouldn't have been doing and I wasn't getting paid for. And I found that the more I complained, then the more I was seen as a nuisance.
When you go into an entry-level job after university or after college, sixth form, wherever you come from, you'll be belittled no matter what because you're an entry-level role. But when it comes to males, like, you know, discriminating you for just being a woman, you know, like, oh, you must be on your period today, no wonder you're so moody, that sort of attitude. You have to stand your ground and say, actually, no, I don't really appreciate you saying that.
You know, you just come along just to give people a cup of tea or to take their lunch order, and they just kind of, like, look you up and down and, you know, have a conversation with your breasts instead of your face. And then also, like, because my mum works in the film industry as well, and there's been times when she's been turned down a job because she has children and because she's a woman.
I haven't yet experienced very, like, direct sexism in the industry, but obviously I'm always hearing of experiences around me, and it's also the kind of everyday things that occur in the film industry.
What I find is there are more females in the industry than we think, so it's not so much a matter of there's no women in the industry. There are, but we're all in certain areas. We're not in very many of the technical areas, and I suppose growing up you kind of didn't envision yourself in those roles, therefore you went for other roles such as costume and makeup, etc., and that's fine, but there's a real lack of women in editing and sound and camera and sparks and grips and all these things. And I have found working as a woman at times quite challenging.
We've had people come in from these industries and they've been predominantly male, and there's been times where we've all thought, you know, why did we not get any females come through? And that's when we actually did some research and realised there aren't that many female women, like there aren't any women in the industry, in the media industry, especially film side and production side. So one of my friends, housemates, made a group called Female Editors Only, and there's about 800 people who are members, or I think maybe 500 members, and all of them are basically doing the same thing, we're in the same position where we're just not being recognised in that way.
In my course, and from third year, second year and first year, you've got about 60 students in each, and going from third year with about maybe 10 girls, there's then about 20 in second year and a good 25 in the first year, I think I mixed that up. But yeah, there's more and more girls being introduced into the media industry, and I think it's amazing.
You know, what I see are like Facebook posts or ads that are very much just automatically directed at men rather than, you know, looking for a camera person, they'll say cameraman, or they'll say, I'm looking for this person, he must have this.
Be brave at making decisions on your own, and don't feel like you need to be a certain way to succeed. You can be whatever, whoever, what you want to be, despite the images being thrown at you.
Don't let the fact that you're a girl deter you, and just as long as you do your best, your employer shouldn't see your gender or your sex as a reason to not hire you. And if they do, then that's not someone that you want to work for. You know, you want an employer and clients that will respect you and respect your work, and if you're not given that, then you just have to push projects aside, unfortunately.